In this video, we're going to do a short example of how separation of variables can be used to solve a differential equation. So our differential equation will be dy dx equals x times y. The goal with separation of variables is to write all the y terms on one side and all the x terms on another. And that's where the separation comes in. We can do so by dividing both sides by y and multiplying both sides by dx. We've now separated the variables. Now what we'll do is we'll take the antiderivative of each side. Now the antiderivative of dy over y is ln of y. The antiderivative of x dx is 1 half x squared. Now as you recall, when you're taking an indefinite integral, you do need to account for a constant. Now, because we haven't solved for what the constant is yet, we do not need to account for a constant on both sides, only on one side, and since we'll be solving for y, we'll put the constant on the right-hand side. So next step is to solve for y. In order to solve this equation for y, one way of doing so is to make both sides exponents of e. Because the property on the left-hand side says e to the natural log of y is just equal to y. So we have y equals e to the 1 half x squared plus c all in the exponent. Now we could leave it like that and solve for c, but one thing we can typically do with exponential functions, well, property of exponents says we could rewrite this as e to the 1 half x squared times e to the c. Now just like c is a constant, e to the c is a constant, so we do what's called absorbing it into another constant. So for instance, I might call e to the c a. And then a lot of times in the general solution, you'll see the a actually written out in front. So our general solution is y equals a e to the 1 half x squared. So we look at it as a multiplicative constant instead of an additive constant. Now, in order to solve for a, we need an initial condition. So let's say we have the initial condition y of 0 equals 3. That means x equals 0 when y is equal to 3. That's enough information for us to solve for a, because we have e to the 1 half times 0 squared, which is just e to the 0 or 1. So we get a equals 3, and thus our unique solution with this initial condition is 3e to the 1 half x squared.